You, when it comes to pure style. Does anybody do it better than the Italians? Forget about it. You, now in its second year of production. And after nearly three decades in exile from American shores. The Fiat 500 returns for 2013 with the same syrupy sweet sass and sprinkle of sporty goodness that has endeared this city dweller's compact car to so many throughout its storied history. You, but while the car has come to be defined by its small stature, the 500's recent reintroduction begs the question, is this little Italian stallion a one-trick pony? A car purely defined by its small stature? Or does it transcend its city car moniker? And like a modern-day Da Vinci, prove too multifaceted to label with such broad strokes. You, designing a thoroughly appealing car inside and out is a job we certainly don't envy. Okay, so maybe we do a little. Nevertheless, it's a job Fiat's designers have done with great success. While onlookers will undoubtedly be drawn to the car's bubbly exterior, the interior is what actually steals the show. You, inside the design layout is equal parts fun, funky, and functional, for the most part. Think of it as cross between you and a dolly painting and you re nearly there. Hint, the secret word of the day here is crazy awesome. From its two-tone color schemes to the mini-like circular instrument gauges, the 500's interior grabs your attention right away and never lets go. You, it's not all perfect though. While we commend Fiat for placing such a great emphasis on fun, some design choices are questionable. You, for starters, the 500 oddly places window controls on the center console. While a seemingly minor design preference, nearly every drive we took included a moment where we felt utterly disoriented searching for the damn window controls. T, 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 U, instead.